Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Put a hand right on your head, you Luigi brother now. Ooh. Talk to that boy nice. You the real is back. Yo.
RTTV.
Gang, what up? Gang, gang.
And it's your first time here. Definitely won't be your last. So make sure you kill, murder, and
smash
that subscribe button.
And if you guys rock with anime, movies, and a lot more, man, download our Patreon right now. We got One Piece. We got Bleach. We got Mortal Kombat, the new movie, and a lot more. And a yearly subscription will get you a month for free. Join the family.
Yo, do that. Make sure you like this video. Let us know you're rocking with J. Cole. And make sure that notification bell is ringing so every time we drop another video,
you
know about it. First.
And make sure you follow us on Spotify, the RTTV show, where we talk about some of your favorite genres of music, such as K-pop, hip-hop, R&B, and much, much more. So make sure you follow and subscribe Spotify, the RTTV show.
Yo.
And yo, we're back, RTTV, and we here in the brand new... You know where we at.
Where we at?
We in the hip-hop room.
Yes, yeah, sir.
Hip-hop room.
Yes, sir.
We in the K-pop room.
Yeah.
We in the bottle. We just in the music room.
Uh-huh.
And guys, J. Cole is back with a brand new album, and we're here to let you know how it is, yo. This is like the new MTV Yo Raps.
Yes, sir.
You already know what time it is. You're here with the RTTV squad. Yo, we're just going to introduce ourselves because it's been a minute. It's your boy Rob City.
Yo, what's good, man? It's your boy DC.
Yo, this is the man, the myth, the maniac, Wilkins underscore RT.
Patrick RT, baby.
And it's your boy Wells, the anime king.
And we're going to review that new J. Cole album. Fall off season?
The off season.
The off season.
Oh, my fault. The off
Yo,
season.
Yo, Robbie really trying to make my boy
fall off. It was crazy.
It was
a
drink. You see that?
I'm trying to say, yo, it's called the fall off season.
He even said he might have been a fall off. Backwards, too. He said MTV Yo Raps. Like, he just.
That's why, so you saying he's. Forget it.
Yeah.
It's just a Robbie thing. Yeah.
It's just a Robbie thing.
But, guys, we about to get into it. It's been a minute. Our boy J. Cole's last time he dropped the album was 2018 with KOD. Then he dropped Revenge of the Dreamers compilation tape. And now he's back with the album that he's been teasing for years.
Mm-hmm.
He's been working on these projects for a minute. We just watched the documentary. If you haven't already, make sure you check it out.
Yeah.
It's fire. J. Cole just letting people know, like, yo, he feels he's in a comfortable place. And before he falls off, let me drop at my peak right now. Let me drop you some music because he's going to take a break and he's about to ball.
Yep.
Where's he bowling?
Rwanda.
Boy, playing off for the people.
Yes, sir.
Professional. He's now a professional basketball player, and he's the first rapper to be on the Slam cover without another sports star on it with them.
That's what's up.
Yeah, that man slid on them freestyles, too.
Oh, yeah. LA Leakers, yeah, that's for sure.
Still tipping beat.
Mike Jones. Oof.
I can't wait for him to bust like Damian Lillard's ass and ball. Like, that's the day I'm like, yo, J. Cole, you got all my respect. It's gonna come.
Why? Yeah, I don't know why he thought that would be a day that was
Damian Lillard. J. Cole time, baby.
Damian Lillard raps, maybe that's why.
Nah, but that's actually a great point. Yeah, he's the real rapper baller out here, baby.
Yeah, I thought you were saying because he wants to rap. Damian Lillard wants to rap and J. Cole wants to ball. I thought that's what you were saying.
He's not going to bust Damian Lillard.
When Dame out rap J. Cole will out ball Dame. I'll put it that way. Yeah. I'll put it that way.
All right, well, we're about to get right into it. J. Cole, the off season, the first track, 95 South. We all know that highway.
For real.
Yes.
Wow. That's a legendary highway on the East Coast.
Yep.
Ooh.
2021 new music.
Jermaine
Cole opened the world with this.
Facts,
everybody drop.
What?
He got a free to let's go.
Is this a song that came up before? Like, too easy for me now.
What's the sample?
Woo!
Oh, there's that Jay-Z sample. I can't believe
these fucking clowns. Talk to him. Everybody clapping when your 30 song album do a measly 100,000.
Put an M right on your head, you Luigi brother now. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Mario ass.
Put an M right on your head, you Luigi brother now. Ooh. Talk to that boy nice. You the know. Real is back.
Yo, you know when Cam'ron sets it off. You already know what time it's on. Yo, Cam'ron set that off. J. Cole with the bars. Yo, the production. I want to know who produced it.
I think that sample. I think that sample from.
You don't know.
Yeah, it's you don't know. Yeah, that is you don't know.
You don't know. Even it's kind of his flow is kind of similar.
Yeah, that's how you start off an album. Killer. Once I heard Killer, I went crazy.
What?
Y'all know.
Oh, vibe back.
And y'all know. Every time I hear a beat, I'm always like Killer. Like a random beat. So yeah,
I needed a feature in the first. That's how I was like, yes, I needed. I needed a hit. So. Energy with J. Cole, Cam'ron and J. Cole. Come bro. On. Crispy cream dreams. Sometimes my dogs want to kill 12. Because they said they harassing. We seen dilemmas like Nelly. Wow. In a billion's fashion. My young niggas nutty, they blasted.
Nah, you know what he said?
Yo, when you hear my car tomorrow, just know it's. All you hearing is Cole.
He said Krispy Kreme flow. My boys want to kill 12. Because they 12 donuts in a pack of Krispy Kreme.
Wow. What? Oh, wow. Cole's in his
my
bag.
My dogs want to kill 12.
Motherfucker.
No,
John. Hey!
What?
Intro, bro.
Wow.
Oh, that's he started an album right there.
That is up there with one of the greatest intros I've heard.
That really is.
I heard Cam'ron and Lil Jon. I think that's the crazy thing about it is they didn't even rap. Yeah. But my whole thing is that's what I want from J. Cole. I wanted to hear him bounce off of other energies from other rappers. It's like a ball player that never gets to play, a superstar ball player that you never see play in an all-star game and never see real players. And it's like, just that little bit was enough. Was like, yo, Cam'ron with the ad-libs, Lil Jon with the ad-libs. That's all. Like, I just need J. Cole to bounce off some energies because J. Cole is just,
I have to say, that's a great way to start an album, especially in 2021, because he brought, like, a lot of the old generation, like, rappers from the 2000s with Cam'ron and Lil Jon, and then he got the You Don't Know sample from Jay-Z. So it's, like, to introduce that new generation to that old sound and just give them bars, like, that was a great way to set off the album right there, bro.
Yo, I love Cam'ron talking about
him. Yeah.
Cam'ron's still one of the smoothest. Like, I honestly believe that. Even watching his Drink Champs, like, Cam'ron's still that dude. And, yo, I really believe what J. Cole was saying, like, in his documentary and what he's been saying about his album. Like, yo, this is, like, his pen sharp. Like, you could tell he really sat down and made sure he took no bars off on this shit. So,
and I ain't gonna lie, yo, the interlude, the freestyles, those were just... This is where it's like, yo, nah, this is the J. Cole I want. Like, the other stuff, those were nothing. This, and I like how it's just like, yo, I'm going to give y'all a little taste. I'm going to give y'all a little something. Just wait for it. Then right when album dropped, that energy, this is the J. Cole that we want.
Everything before was just him stretching.
Yeah, this is that freestyle J. Cole. Like, we about to get to the next track, Amari. Amari?
Probably Amari. Oh, I haven't looked at the track list. I don't know.
I ain't even looking at this shit.
It's Amari.
We're about to get right into it. Track 2. If you're listening on Spotify, shout out to you.
Yes, sir.
Off season.
I feel like this beat gonna
this
come
is
in crazy.
This is him in the off season. Hey.
I knew it.
I like the bounce to this. Good feeling to do crumping. That's true. I seen it.
Is that what?
A good, what I say? A good cup?
It's something good cup will keep a fiend crumping. I know that. Yeah. It's a good cup keep a fiend crumping.
Yeah, exactly. That's what it is. Yeah.
This song's fire.
He's
bro.
Gliding on this.
Like
one,
he's
right?
Spazzing yeah, on this, bro.
Real talk, and I feel like with him, he has so much emotion behind his lyrics, though. It's like I feel like with this album, it's like he has a lot that he had to get off his chest right here on Baby.
Yeah, for sure.
I think there's something very different from the two songs that we've heard. There's something very different about the production so far, because I feel like a lot of the J. Cole production, it ain't this. You know what I'm saying? I love to hear him on these kind of beats, because I feel like this is kind of up to date to what we're hearing in hip hop nowadays. And I feel like he was always different in the sense where he was making his own beats. You know what I'm saying? He wanted to stand apart from everybody else in the game. Mm-hmm. Well, I feel like in this case, like the sound in terms of the beat is more on par with what we're listening to, and the lyrics that he usually gives us is still there.
Yeah, I feel like it's like features with producers. Yeah, like, you feel me? Did you say that like this one, the track list, is show that he's working with a lot of different producers?
Yeah, it had a bunch of different producers when he dropped that, I know.
Yeah, and I definitely have to say, like, he's doing a very good job of just, like, keeping his own sound and still incorporating the new sound with the music that he's, with the song that he just did right here. Like, this is a bop. Like, this is a joint that I'm going to be running to. You know what I'm saying? Like, the joint that gets you amped.
Like that bass hit my heart.
Yeah.
Real talk.
I'm about to get into track number three, My Life.
My Life be like.
Yo, Jay. Try not to lean too far because you're cut out.
Okay. Yeah.
Come on a little bit more.
Man, I don't want to take you.
I like the build up.
Spiraling up, just like a wrist in your staircase. No fly zone, please stay the fuck out my airspace.
Spiraling up, just like
niggas say things on my back. Now when I'm done with these songs, you gon' miss me. John Moran, I'm.
Wow. I like that.
What do you say about John Morant?
He was about to go in.
Like the fact that he was like, yo, the cops came to the door for an informant, but I'm not going to give him nothing because I'm God's witness. Mm-hmm. I just like how he played on that. Right? I'm not going to witness for y'all, but I'll witness for God, though. I got him.
Strife is my time now, my world, my life.
Say
what? The stuff that I seen,
I'm
trying to
tell. 21.
I
knew it.
Yay! Hey!
Yep.
I got a good heart, so I seen teddy bears every time we met their mama's cry.
Yeah. Ooh, come on, 21.
Yo, that's sick.
Ooh,
wow. I'm still giving my heart to Doug Hoes because that's who's accepting me.
Yo, wow. 21 Savage, the fact that he could keep up with J. Cole, the fact that he could keep up with Drake, like every time he gets on track one of these legends, he keeps up. I just want to see him on a song with Kendrick now. Like,
yeah, right?
Yeah.
A lot. This track. I want to see him keep up with Kendrick, too.
And shout out to J. Cole's, like, yo, that A Lot song was one of the biggest songs. You feel
one
me?
One of the Grammys. It's definitely one of his most successful.
He just, he was like, yo, you know what? Toy, let me repay the favor real quick. I got you. And it's like, you're right. This gives you the feel of A Lot.
Now, I feel like it's like 21. Let me repay you.
Yo, bro. Yeah. I feel like literally the song should be called A Lot Part 2. Like, from the way the beat is, from the sample to the way they rapped on it. Like, when Cole came in, I really was like, how many faking their streams? I felt that shit. But I really like the vibe of this song, though. When J. Cole's in this bag, like, talk about, like, J. Cole's one of the best at that.
And so, kind of piggybacking off of what Rob said, I like that 21 was able to keep up with J. Cole on this, because there's not a lot of rappers that could keep up with J. Cole, especially within the new generation. So, like, 21, you definitely did your thing on this track.
Hell yeah. I love 21.
21 was a legend, bro.
He is, 21,
20, Tolliver. My life. I feel like it's probably like a Dreamville artist. That
probably.
I just don't know
we got Jake. I mean, we got 21, Cameron, Lil Jon, yo. If he don't got no more features, man, I'm satisfied, bro. Three. The last two, I'm like 21, one of my favorites.
And I've never heard somebody say, yo, I'm going to disrespect you respectfully. That just sounds disrespectful, but then respectful at the same time. So shout out to 21, person that could really do that and say that, and it sounds actually really smooth, yo.
And did he actually say that he sends teddy bears to people's moms that he bodied?
Yeah,
like that's crazy.
Yeah, that's
like that was like wait, he's too savage, bro.
Yeah, like I don't know if you know my face, I'm like, yo, that's kind of crazy, yo.
Where's the savage? Bro. What do you expect, bro? Savage mode continues.
We're about to get into track number four, Applying Pressure.
Mm.
And if you're on Spotify, make sure you add this to your playlist.
Yeah, do that.
Yeah.
What's that boom bop?
Yeah. A$AP Rocky.
He's on it?
Yeah.
He's guessing. It's not like he'll be awesome like this, though.
That would be fire, though. Yeah. He would kill this shit. Applying pressure, starting my crime with crime festers, and now I'm showing like they in their second trimesters. That's why we niggas throw a shot or two online. I pay no mind to their benign gestures. Nigga, please, I got my mind on much bigger things to say the least. My latest speeches sound like they was released by David East. Versus hit hard, never pitched hard to play the streets. These niggas whips hard behind closed doors, can't pay the lease. Wrong with living check to check, cause most have to. Instead of capping, why don't you talk about being a broke rapper? Cause it's real, what it's like to be nice as fuck. But how you doing? Sometimes you gotta do it in front of this fucking face. So here, no fair. Damn, that nigga did it how I always wanted to do it. Now I'm never gonna do it like that.
You got the platinum. I feel like that was a real song, because I feel like he's more so challenging, or even coming at the rap artists nowadays who are just lying on their verses or whatever. Yeah. Like, if you really want to be a real nigga, rap about how broke you are. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Rap about the struggle coming up as a rapper. Like, you rap about that, or rap about the stuff you ain't even got yet. That's a real nigga. Rap about how broke you are. And I respect that.
Yeah. That's a generation. A lot of this generation is all about, like, glamorizing things that they don't have and stuff like that, just to fit, like, you know, the status quo right now, what it is and stuff. So I feel you on that.
Shout out to my nigga Pooh Shicey, though. He eat church's chicken with designers.
Yeah. Don't get realer than that.
We about to get into track number 5, Punching the Clock.
Wow,
I got more cribs than habitat.
Wow.
Ooh.
Died over a cross, just like
the start of Christianity.
Beautiful.
Wow. Damn, he said, I got more houses in.
They habitat for humanity.
Yeah, my oh friend, my yeah.
Why he like that?
59 seconds. He got a lot of. That Damian Dollar.
Yeah, I knew he sounded familiar. Yeah, it's Damian Lillard. It's Damian Lillard.
I had no idea, bro. I had no
That's
idea,
hilarious.
Bro.
That is hilarious.
So he had the Dame Lillard
feature. Beat him in the ball game.
Was it? I mean,
that's Damian Lillard. I knew I recognized his voice. I just couldn't tell.
We about to get into the. That was a fire song. J. Cole definitely went in for that good amount of time, and I like the talking on the album, because I feel like I love albums where the artist sometimes can just sit there and talk to you, even if it's not him.
Mm-hmm.
Like giving Damian Dollar, who works hard, who punches the clock every literally when he needs to. So I'm definitely rocking with that song.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, and he hasn't missed on a track yet.
Nah, I feel like this is definitely Drake. Oh, I said Drake. J. Cole is like basically saying.
How's you slip?
Why you do that?
Certified lover boy coming real.
I think about Dame Lillard D in my head pose.
Hey,
yo, we going to the next track, man.
Like,
track number 6.
I knew that said.
Track number 6, 100 mil. Let's get to it. Wow.
Oh my mind.
I think this is going to have a feature. I'm calling it.
This one?
Yeah. The J feature that we've been saying.
Do you all consider Damian Dollar a feature?
Yeah, bro. I think Damian Dollar on it. Nah, you think Damian Aston? Can I rap?
No, this isn't going to be the J feature.
This sound like Drake could be on it.
I see what you mean.
This album's fire, yeah.
You think it's Kanye West's choir?
For real?
They say you think it is.
Oh, no, I thought you said you know this is Kanye West's choir. I was about to be like, oh.
Wow, man. We can play this going to church, bro.
I'm surprised in that track.
Why you say that?
Because it was short. I just don't, like, I didn't picture J. Cole or making a song about $100 million, making $100 million, and still grinding for more. Cause I remember him. I think it was on Angie Martinez when he's talking about like material things and like not like. Never having enough money. You know what I'm saying? So like, it's just surprising that he would make a song about having $100 million and trying to make more.
His aspirations probably changed, though. He probably, there's probably certain things that he noticed what he needs more money for and stuff like that. Especially probably going out to Rwanda. Probably noticed different things and things that he can't do with the amount of money he got. Possibly.
I think he's more happy that like J. Cole, like a lot of things that he's talking about, like he got $100 million and like everything ain't changed. Like I still got my same girl. Like I still got my same homies. My homies ain't switch up on me. $100 million, I'm still going. Like $100 million, I'm not a, I don't hate my, I don't hate my life type shit. Like I think that's more what he was trying to get at. Like I'm $100 million and I'm in a good place mentally. Like I got good people around me. I'm not worried about all that other bullshit.
It's like $100 million and I'm still J. Cole. You know what I'm saying? Like I'm still doing what I'm doing and I'm not doing too much. Like I'm not out here trying to flex. Like I'm just letting you know that $100 million and I'm still working. Like the grind just doesn't stop. No matter if I'm playing ball, no matter if I'm rapping, whatever it is.
Nah, you're right. You know he rich too, cause he was on LA Leakers. I swear he had no lineup too. And he got $100 million. So that's like, that's what shows humbleness.
Bro, he said it in one of the freestyles. He said some shit like, I used to dress bummy. Sometimes I still do, but now it's by choice.
Yeah.
Like he was like, but if you look in my closet, I forgot what he said. If you look in my closet, it looked like something. Like, so he's like, I got the shit. I just I could look broke because I'm rich. Nigga.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
It don't matter.
We're about to get in track number 7, Pride is the Devil.
It sounds like some Latin song. I don't know.
Yeah.
It sounds like salsa to me.
It sounds like a Tiger song. I don't know what Tiger song I'm thinking of.
I could do without that song.
So far, that's my least favorite.
Yeah,
I mean, I don't know for sure. Man. Like, it could change up on me, but.
Was it because he compared it to Tiger?
Tiger? That was the most experimental, like, J. Cole, like, singing, like, wise, like.
Are you talking about that song of YG, like, yo? The, Go Loco.
Yeah.
Go
Loco. Oh, wow.
These dudes is dumb, yo.
Yeah, I can do without this song.
Nah, it really does. We're about to get back into it. I like that song.
If J. Cole say, Aria,
I actually like
I'm
that song.
Crazy.
That's a crazy flow. Hello, baby.
Oh.
Nah, I like the way Lil Baby came in on that first,
I did
though.
It.
But
do I like the fast Lil Baby, yo?
Nah, you just don't like Lil Baby.
No, I love Lil Baby. I really do love Lil Baby. This one's like J. Cole. It sounded like to me this will happen, right? J. Cole, you think you're a better rapper than me? Rap on this beat. Rap on this for him.
Nah, it's just messed up. Cause J. Cole probably had his best flow on this song right before Lil Baby came in, and it was just like, ooh. It's like Lil Baby caught the alley from Drake. That one he might have rimmed stuff.
Nah, but like the only reason why I think the only reason why I like the way he came in was because how J Cole was flowing throughout the verse.
That part.
That's why I'm saying the beginning of that Lil Baby verse. I was like, oh snap, Lil Baby. You know what I'm saying? But like the song as a whole, I don't know if I'm here for it.
The pride is never
over. I rock with it. Like, I truly think this is a banger. Like, J. Cole, this is definitely one of the top songs out here.
This is better than the
Tiger?
No, the first single he did.
The Interlude?
The Interlude?
Oh, yeah.
Nah, this is definitely better than Interlude.
Yo, bro,
stop playing.
Yeah.
What are you talking about, bro?
This is definitely better than the Climax. This is definitely better than the Climax.
No.
Yo, y'all
don't do that.
Yo, y'all don't like that type of music. That's fine, but that's a lane of music.
Yeah, you know exactly. Pride is the devil.
No, what is
that? Pride is the devil.
Yeah, you showing a lot of pride right now, bro.
What is that?
That's this song. What you talking about?
Yo, Rob's a fool. He don't really like this song.
Wait, what happened?
I heard it for the first time. I don't remember the name. How did you forget that part?
Yeah, but it's a hook.
Pride is the devil. I ain't gonna lie. That's probably the part I like the least is the hook.
I know.
Honestly, I just don't like the pride is the devil part. Literally, everything else was fire. And I'm going to play this in Mexico. And when we play this in Mexico, I hope
I'm gonna turn up to it.
Energy. I'm not going to be turned up.
We're going to be drunk.
He's going to be trying to fight somebody to this song.
Wait, why was y'all fighting?
We are solid. I'm going to be drunk, and I might actually sit down when he play this song. I'm going to be like, ah.
We about to get into the next track, track number 8, Let Go of My Hand.
We'll pass that to a shorties.
Ooh. It sounds like NBA Streets.
It really does.
It's like a real J. Cole sound right here.
Is that 90s?
I found this instrumental on my phone while on vacation.
Worse.
Sent it a year ago or so. I probably heard it before. I slept on it, you know. Shit don't always connect as soon as you press play. At times you gotta step away, do some living. Let's talk about a new prescription, give them truer vision. I dibble dabble in a few religions. My homie constantly telling me about Quran.
Okay, Cole, talk your ish, boy.
Recognize the wisdom in it, but I ain't got the discipline for sticking with it. Now I'm on the way.
Tell him, man.
Boy, rapping, boy.
Yeah. Introspective right here, bro. Right. Cole, this is the retrospective, introspective J. Cole right here. You feel me? Taking us on a little time travel right here, you know, through his mind.
If you're going to say two pectives, you better define both of them.
Right. Retrospective is when you flash back and think about like an old memory. Introspective is more interior thoughts.
That's why retro. Pat was an English major. Talk to him nice.
That was cataclysmic.
Talk to him nice.
That was cataclysmic.
You better listen to Baby Trav, bro.
That's Travis Knott. I told you that already.
Oh my gosh. Hey, oh.
Respect to my hair.
He said that's Travis Knott.
Yeah.
Imagine right. That the beat just changed up and Travis Scott here.
Ooh.
Ooh. Straight up.
Ooh. It's lit.
The beat right. Remember, he found the instrumental. He's like, let y'all know he found this instrumental, boy. Shoot, Cole said, you better listen to this instrumental. I should have just, rap to it, Ev. Come on. You got that. That's what he did. Come on, dude, spin your thing. You on a J. Cole song. All right,
well,
not so much pressure. Oh, man, you want the shot? Nah, this dude just scared.
Menace the menace, I'm getting pennies, bruh.
Pennies getting the hennies, bro. What? I'm telling to take a bad trip to Denny's, yo.
Why Denny's, though?
Because a bad trip. Ended up at Denny's.
Like, yo, Denny's,
now,
no.
Anytime somebody let it be right out, we home freestyle, too.
Every single time. All right, that's the code right now.
Well, I'm going to give y'all a classic on one of these reactions.
So I mean, I always get ready next.
I got you. I'm gonna give y'all a classic.
You got
stay
him real
tuned.
Nervous right there. He was
he
like,
froze
oh,
up.
Yeah,
yeah. He said,
yeah, I was like,
he said,
I started thinking.
Said,
I was like, yo,
J. Cole
what?
Might see this. He's like, nah. They don't actually see this.
I said, wait a minute.
He's like, hold on,
yo,
bro.
Yo, he about to do the off season. I'm trying to get in the game.
I was like, nah, in the season.
Yeah, like shit, bro. If he leaving the game, put me on.
That's why I get in the G League at least.
You feel me?
But yo, I ain't gonna lie to you. That's my favorite J. Cole. Like, I like that. There's a new rapper that could make me hear that 90s Tribe Called Quest type of vibes. And I love that boom back sound. And I think J. Cole, that's what Jay-Z signed him, because he heard him on that sound, but he made it sound 20. Well, at that time, new. But, like, it sounds like 2021. And I like how he let us know the process of actually finding the beat.
Yeah, right?
And you know what I'm saying? Like, pretty much the beginning rap was about finding the beat. And it's like, yo, beats is that. The album to him, like, I don't know how to explain it. I don't know. Like, it's just.
He never discarded it. He's like, I wonder how long ago he heard the beat versus a when he surfaced the beat into his, like, his mind and stuff like that. You know what I mean? Nah, y'all don't feel me.
But we about to get into the next track number 9 and 10, which is Joel Evans' favorite track, number 9, The Interlude.
Woo! Hey! Yo, well, you ain't gonna rap our joint, bro?
No, this isn't my joint.
That's crazy.
Make sure you check out reaction to that. And track number 10, make sure you check out reaction to that too, The Climb Back.
Yep.
This is Evan's song.
I fuck with this song.
Back around full circle. It'll hurt you.
And we about to get into track number 11, Close.
Yeah.
You got to make the song cry on this one.
Yeah. That's what it sounds like. Well, at least the vocals in the background. One time.
If he does have the Jay feature, this is a Jay feature.
Nah, this is a Nas feature. What you thought?
Nas right? feature? I stare at my dreams as they approach. Gotta be patient and trust in God. He the coach. Temptations are taking a shortcut, but I don't. I ain't trying to be an almost when I get it. Nah. Gone are the days we was close. Tell him, Cole. When I see you, I look at you just like a ghost. Uh-huh. I'm telling your former self, so caught up with that dope. Yeah. Two niggas singing two different notes, and you know I got a coast. Tell him. But a dollar and some hope.
Up in the wild, but damn, what hurts me to... Dollar and a dream tour. Dollar of hope. What's your scope?
I don't know why I feel like either like Jay-Z or Nas gonna hop on this one right here, man. I'm hoping
they all busy hopping on this one together, bro. But they're kings. They got their own stuff.
What if they got Jay-Z and Nas going back and forth on this?
They can do it for DJ Khaled. They can do it for Cole.
You can't say that. You cannot. A lot of people do stuff with DJ Khaled they would not do for a lot of people. So that is not DJ Khaled.
Jay-Z's artist.
DJ Khaled is, and that, yo, and that shows how much people love DJ Khaled. DJ Khaled is the most loved person in the world, bro. Easily, bro. The stuff people do for him, I'll never understand.
I be throwing off. I'm like, why? Yeah.
We about to get back.
Shout out to DJ Khaled. In the stars, in the lean, in the coat, and I swear in that moment I wish we were still close. Maybe I could have saved you with no trigger squeeze gun smoke. I opened up my eyes with a joke, heart pumping like Usain Bolt. Reach for my phone, missed calls, and a text message note from my mama saying you just got smoked. Then this life is no joke.
Yeah, I knew there was gonna get no feature on this. This is one of them J. Cole talking about like.
No. Be riding out.
Yo, damn, this is ready to go. Track. You know it's not whack. I'm counting stacks.
Oh, he's
I'm
really rapping. Black.
Jerry Wilkins over here, and I'm always talking facts. I count my money to the ceiling, yet I stack to stack. Ooh. If we talking racks, I live with my nigga Pat. You will get smacked.
That's what we're talking racks?
I don't know.
If we're talking racks, look at Pat. Yo, I got look at him.
If we're talking he's racks, got
the
rack. Got
yo, where the little Duval?
Yo, damn. He was talking some real shit on that one though. People he was close
nah,
to.
Nah, y'all were disappointed.
Nah, why? What he said? I didn't catch it.
Nah, he was talking about.
Nah, keep it real. They're disappointed. They wanted J. Cole to have a feature on it. J. Cole didn't deliver what they wanted.
Speak for yourself.
Yeah,
what?
Are
you
speaking for me?
I know that. I didn't mean to say anything say anymore. Nah, thank you.
I said he wasn't gonna be on it. I literally said he would have.
I wanted. Nah, I definitely said.
Same manager? Would you say both of you?
Yeah. Nah. I definitely said. Yo, I could hear if. He had a feature with Jay, would be on this track, but I wouldn't be surprised if Jay is not on this album at bro, the same time too. Because Jay ain't been on a Cole album since his first album.
Nice watch.
Now,
that was like 2011.
I would definitely have wanted to hear a Jay verse.
Yo, who wouldn't?
I just know that it wouldn't. I just knew it wasn't gonna be on this one. Like he was talking about like how. People that he was really close to, we chose different places in life, and you see how different that went for that person.
Yeah, you saying that's Jay-Z?
No,
he's saying that's
your song.
I'm like, wait. He was talking to Jay-Z. That's what I'm like, what was I listening
like,
to?
He's talking about like somebody doing like his boy doing drugs, like, and how that changed that person and shit like that.
To save him.
Yo, Rob just mad because this is better than Laugh Not Cry.
Nah, I love this. No. This is way better. I don't
hate
like
Laugh Not Cry.
I hate that song.
Laugh Not Cry.
Yo, this is definitely better than Drake demo tapes. And you said demo tapes like is gonna be better than J. Cole's project.
I never said that. Speak for yourself, Rob. Yo, speak for yourself.
You see, I said Laugh Not Cry Later. I don't. It's not better than this.
I hear you play it every time when you run in the morning.
We about to get into the next track.
Our next door neighbor is God think Robbie a Stone Cold Killer. Robbie outside in the morning. I kill it.
If I had to run to Laugh Now Cry Later, bro, I don't think I'll ever run again.
He might cry now and laugh.
No, I heard it, guys.
We about to get into Hunger on Hillside, the last track. Oh, y'all ready, fellas?
I'm ready.
Turn the music up in the headphones.
Turn the lights down. I'm in my zone. J. Cole, you heard?
Hours.
Nigga don't get stepped on.
Yeah.
But respect on. Still gonna be me when success gone. I don't speak the language of cowards. I won't.
Yo, don't close it. Yo, you hate it.
We got to. We have to. They'll take this video down. We have to pause it. You see, Jordan don't like this video. He wants it to get taken down. He say, don't stop. Yeah, you see how messed up he is.
Talk about it. Why is he rocking with it, right?
I haven't heard
enough.
I haven't heard enough. So far, he didn't say nothing to me so far.
No, what about the beat, though? You don't like the beat?
The beat's fire, yeah. I like how he's doing
production. This is the best Jago production in the last 15 years.
No, it's not. Born Sinner is still better production-wise compared to this.
Well,
like,
no, if you, I thought you was going to say Friday Night Lights.
No. And Forest Hills.
Oh, I was going to say, 2014 might be. Still, probably his best album to me.
Yeah,
Boyson is my shit too.
Forest Hills, Forest Hills.
That don't got
that
one feature.
What does that matter, bro? Because you don't like J. Cole. Like, what you want me to tell? Robbie said there's nobody else on it.
Drake's on Friday Night Lights.
But what does that mean?
What's that mean?
That don't mean shit to me.
Better than 24 Forest Hills.
Friday Night Lights, the mixtape you're saying? I like that mixtape.
Why you lying, Joel?
I like that mixtape.
Joel, why you lying?
You like Laugh Now, Cry Later. Stop. Stop.
What song is that?
Yo, we about to get
hating,
back into
he hating on J. Cole.
Yo,
come on,
no,
man.
I like J. Cole. You know what? Like, Dark Knight. That's why he just went and got Kanye's people. Every time I hit it, it sounds like some Kanye shit, bro. This don't sound like a Kanye song.
I mean, J. Cole's done this before, though.
No, but this really sounds like Kanye West, bro. Like,
it does, though. It does.
It's like a song. No, this has a sample. What song is it sample from?
It sounds familiar.
That was the beat right out.
Pat, where you at? Talking about this beat is whack.
About you say do not stir, so I'm a tester. Yeah, I'm a big money, yeah, big flexer. Ooh. Yeah, hitting her on the phone, I'm a sexter. Yeah, you already know she in my room, so I stretch her.
Yeah. Like you doing yoga. Flex like you Hulk Hogan. Oops, I'm at Hogan. You get the slogan.
He said flex like you Hulk Hogan. Nope, you Hulk Hogan. Stop playing.
Oops, I'm at Hogan. You know the slogan.
And guys, we officially made it through J. Cole's the off season.
Shout out Cole, man.
And Jawal's playing music in the background.
Damn, that's you. Robbie chopping everything.
That's not him. You here right there.
That's
you. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, that's definitely Wells. Why you? Damn, bro. We just finished this album, bro.
My phone is not playing music.
Wait, what's...
It could be the other house. Wait.
I never even heard that song.
They get a crack in that show. Yeah.
You thought they just built a whole new house to do nothing? Oh, my fault. Niggas getting cracking over there.
Yo, my fault. They're playing music in the background. But nah, honestly, though.
Nah, there's no way that's not.
It has to be in the house. Check your rooms. Check both y'all rooms.
It's not my room. I know that. I don't even know what the fuck song this is, nigga.
I can check my
room. Yo, what y'all play to this TV?
Niggas got
you would.
But we're back with the off season, man. My boy Joe wants to interrupt a great J. Cole's best album since Friday Night Lights. Nice. This production on this album, the intro itself, that was one of the best intros I heard in the past 5 years. That's up there with Meek Mill's intro. That's up there with the Drake intros. And the Baby has one of the greatest intros, too. Joel knows what song I'm talking about. Shout out to Charlotte, Carolina, North Carolina, Carolina people listening right now. But honestly, 95 South.
Carolina.
95 South, though, honestly, bro, like, I don't even, like, I haven't felt like that in a minute, bro. Like, that way J. Cole capitalized this album, I feel like it was good. He had two of Atlanta's hottest features.
Yep.
Little Baby and 21, who are two of my favorites. And then he had Cameron, and he had amazing samples. And not only that, too, I truly like the Little Baby song. I can't wait to bump that in Mexico. And shout out to my boy Winfield, yo. J. Cole, he's one of your biggest fans. And
yes,
he's going to think this is better than everything, too.
I think he already texted us, too. I'm not even going to hold you.
He definitely did.
So this is from a J. Cole stan, you guys. If you know J. Cole stans, and
he just said, "What albums.
Do you?" He just said, "What do you think?" Okay, well,
mad at some
telling him what we think right now.
We'll just send him the link to this.
Definitely got to say with them first six songs, he did not miss, not at all.
The first six songs.
To 100 mil, he didn't miss. That Pride Is the Devil, and then everything else is cool, you know.
Yeah,
aside from the interlude.
Yeah, this, I don't know. This album was like,
It started off very strong for me, and then it just ended up being very, like, cool for me. Like, it wasn't, like, stand out to me and stuff. Like, I feel like production-wise, like, you know, he stayed tailored to, like, J. Cole sound and everything. The most standout song to me was the 21 Savage in the intro. But other than that, I feel like he really just gave us, like, a update to where he is to right now and stuff like that when it comes to what he was spitting about. But I'm still taking Born Center over this, yo. I'm not going to hold you.
Friday Night Lights.
I can't lie to you. I'm a huge Born Center fan, too. So yeah, like, I can't lie. That's still one of my joints, too. But I think Cole did his shit on this one, man. I think he did what he set out to do, man. Like, he is undoubtedly top three rappers of our generation. Like, it's him, Kendrick, and Drake.
He's on a rap Mount Rushmore. He said
is.
It.
He is. I think Cole on this album used more flows than I've ever heard him use. Mm-hmm. Like, the way he was sliding in and out the pocket on some of these songs, like, I was like, bro, I didn't even know Cole was rapping like that. Like, the way he floated on some of these shits, I was like, yo. Cole was, like, in prime shape. You could tell, like, I would say he's in some of his best, like, rap shape in terms of his career that I've seen. And those first six, I'll agree with you, are probably my favorites. Mm-hmm. But I think if the Climb Back dropped today, I would probably think it was one of the better albums on the song. And I do like the last two tracks. I think they're close.
I know what you mean. Better songs.
Yeah, better songs on the album. My fault.
I agree, too.
And then I think 11 Close is like a real J. Cole track to me. Like, I feel like that could have came off of like For Your Eyes Only-esque track. And then like The Hunger on Hillside is a J. Cole joint. Like, yo, at the end of the day, y'all gonna respect this talent. Like, all the rest of that shit, whatever. But this talent right here... That's what I stand on. So shout out to Cole, man. Been a fan forever. Been to mad concerts, man. Shout out to Wynn. I went to that concert with you like 2 years ago, man. So shout out Cole, man. We gonna be at the next one too.
Yeah, first listen, like I think it's because of the B selection on like 1 through 5. I really enjoyed it. You know what I'm saying? The other ones, because it was a little different, I don't think I was able to digest what he was saying, especially like when you got. Like Drake stands in the background yelling about his sounds like Tyga, and then like saying it's the best album since the Friday Night Lights when it was definitely mixed, better. Like, you know what I'm saying? Nah, it was hard to digest.
This is definitely
sometimes.
Better than Life of Pablo, Kanye West, and it might be better than Dark Twisted Fantasy. Wow.
Pablo?
No, like I think this album
right
is that good. Pablo? Yes, it's definitely better than Life of Pablo. Rapping
it's
wise,
not
better
than
he's
Life
rapping wise.
Okay,
rapping wise, bar for bar,
and beat wise, he's up to par. So what are you talking about?
No, beat wise, Life of Pablo is way better. When you come about lyrics, yes, he outbarred Kanye.
Beats,
yes,
he's not up there, and his bars are way better than Kanye's. Like, what are you talking
yo,
about, bro?
Bar for bar, you're absolutely
like
right, bro.
That's what y'all talking about.
He has some
he
shit
took
to
a Panda song and y'all improved it.
Kanye has some features on Life of Pablo. Some great features on Life of Pablo.
And maybe that and designer like, on that album.
Yeah, yo, like, even I feel like even the songs that sound like Kanye S at the end of the beats were better than it would have sounded on Life of Pablo too. That's why I was just like, yo,
like 30 hours. Sounds, yeah. I know none of those songs are better than
hours
30
no, I'm
hours.
Talking about like the Wolves. Old Kanye sound. The Wolves is not old. Like
you're talking about like the Prismizer, like, bro. Like the thing like where it sounds like the that's what it's called.
But what songs like is he referring to on Life of Pablo? That this
there's not too.
Life of Pablo didn't capture that old Kanye sound. I'm saying J. Cole captured that old Kanye sound from the College Dropout, Late Registration. That's what those
okay, five, you can say that, but it's still not better.
So I think that's why it's better, too. He rapped better, and he had that Kanye sound and high-quality production, bro.
But just because he had a...
And he told me he's been working on this for years.
I don't
even
want to
he had two of the hottest... He's arguably one of the hottest rappers out right now. Lil Baby is the best rapper. Like, I'll rap Drake on Wants and Needs.
But we didn't get the greatest Lil Baby verse on that. So
you did.
No, we didn't, bro.
I literally said he kept up with him. What do you think?
No, you said that. Yeah, I'm saying that I don't believe. I like the verse that he did with Wants and Needs way more than this. Way more. Like, light years past this, bro. That's what I'm saying. So, like, I'm not going to sit here and say, like, oh, my gosh, because of that Lil Baby verse that he got from right there, it's going to go.
You like
that.
This album, to Mama Jake? Tell me how you like this album.
I liked it. I only listened to it once. I'm not gonna sit here and say it's better than Life of Pablo.
Yeah,
I can't even.
He didn't say Dark Twisted Fantasy. He didn't say Dark Twisted Fantasy.
He said it, bro.
You know what I meant? I meant the Dark Paradise, the Big Sean.
Oh,
that's
right.
Oh, Dark Sky Paradise.
That's what I was saying.
You said Dark Twisted Fantasy.
I said I didn't say that. I said Dark Paradise. I'm pretty sure I said
you said dark fantasy.
I said dark,
you said, you said dark fantasy.
Yeah, you said dark fantasy.
All right, that's how I'm
watching you edit this. You're going
to
see it.
You know, now people try to make me. I'm not crazy now.
Watching you react, you're like, damn, I really did say that. Watch.
Honestly, I can't even compare. Like right now, like
you can't compare to.
I can't compare to no even to J. Cole albums. I have to listen to this way more. Yeah, like I have to listen to it a few more times, especially J. Cole. I love KOD.
You said that, I fully agree. Like, just off a first listen, I like this.
I didn't like KOD, and then I didn't like For Your Eyes, so that's why this one is, like, I got a lot of bad J. Cole albums. Yo, we almost reacted to it with Evan's little cousin, I mean, nephew. That shows you where I...
No, we did react to it.
Yeah, we did. I don't know what you're talking about.
No, I didn't like that album.
Yeah, I think this was KOD. I think this was way better than KOD and For Your Eyes Only, straight up. Like, this is one of my, this is probably one of my favorite J. Cole albums that I've heard, like, off first listen. Because I don't listen to a lot of J. Cole. The production is what got me on this album. Like, I'm not going to hold you. Like I said, the first six songs, like, that's going to be the whole vibe in my car for, like, the next 2 weeks. But, yeah, he did his thing. But as far as it being better than Life of Pablo, take it easy. Like, take it easy, bro.
What about Dark Saturday?
I'm still picking. That's one of Big Sean's best album.
That is Big Sean's best album.
On Twitch was that. Big Sean's Dark Paradise is better than any J. Cole album. That's why.
That's
I said.
A poll.
No, that's not. That's crazy.
Yo, keep it a buck. I don't think it's better than any of them.
That shit is. I don't believe that.
It's better than 80%. I'll give you that. But
I think it's better than KOD. I think it's better than his first album. I think it's better than whatchamacallit For Your Eyes Only.
And Born Sinner?
Nah, it's not better than Born Sinner.
Born Sinner is my favorite J. Cole album.
And Forest Hill Drive are two great albums.
Guys, make sure
comment below, what's your favorite J. Cole album?
Let us know.
Do you feel like Jawal really likes this album? Do you feel like the music in the background is playing off Everest? Do you feel like Patrick is the baby Travi and that he just don't understand this album? Do you guys feel like Everest just didn't really give an honest opinion? And Jerry likes the album too, so shout out to Jerry. Me, Jerry,
Robbie, just giving y'all how he feels.
Yeah.
That's all I'm talking about.
50, yo.
But yo, man, it's your first time here. It definitely won't be your last. Make sure you kill, murder, and
smash.
That's the subscribe button. I go by the name Rob City RT, and you can check out our hip hop playlist, our J. Cole playlist. Link in the description below. We also have hip hop, rock, pop, K pop, Bollywood, and a lot of international music. If there's a genre we haven't covered, make sure you follow and DM us so we can get into that for you. Again, I am the Haitian Prince, that hip-hop guy, that rock guy, that pop guy.
Yo, that's the music guy.
Check out our musical playlist. Shout out to J. Cole. In all seriousness, bro, since we were in high school, you've been killing the game.
Facts.
Being consistent for over 12, 13 years, and it's very motivational for us because we had three great artists to look up to, Drake, you, and Kendrick. Y'all set the standards for just anyone that wants to work in entertainment or music. And we feel like our success is definitely to your music helped us in that path. So thank you, brother, man.
Yo, what's good, man? It's your boy DC, man. Shout out J. Cole, man. I hope we're going to eventually get some other J. Cole. I know it ain't going to be soon, bro. I ain't trying to do that.
Man,
but.
He's balling, bro. You ain't a ball player. We know
facts, bro.
Preparation. He got to go focus.
Man,
the album's called
Off Season.
He's talking about, yo, I don't. Like, what? He literally titled it.
He's going to give me music. Trust me.
You ain't even like this album. Like, why is he ready to think about the next album already? Like, damn, nigga.
I said I didn't enjoy
this.
You just said, yo, I can't wait for the next J. Cole. This nigga's braids is too tight,
yo.
Did
you not just say that?
Yes. So what does that have to do with this album, you stupid bitch?
I just said that.
What does that have to do with this album, you dumb
bitch? Why you ready
to
care about the next one? Focus on this one. Exactly. Shut up, bro.
Yeah, I want to hear all of them. What?
Yeah.
Say I want
my boy.
Clearly, this one was enough for you, bro.
It's not now.
Clearly.
Yo, nigga.
The album's called Off Season.
Let
J. Cole take a break, though. He need a break, bro.
I just said that.
He got kicked.
Did you listen?
He's about to ball.
Do you listen to me or do you just skim through it? That's the problem. Dumb motherfuckers.
Yo, it's... It's the man, the myth, the maniac, Wilkins _ RT. J. Cole has set off the rap game with this album. Like, thank you, J. Cole, for dropping a great album. Really, really enjoyed it. Go on your break, play ball, potentially make it to the NBA.
You,
yeah, we going to watch you. We might react to some of your highlights. Who knows?
Yeah, definitely.
Who knows? But I'm excited. Yo, this album definitely got excited. It has me more excited for the rest of the year and everybody else that's going to drop. It got me excited for Drake, and it got me more excited for Kendrick, too. So.
Yo, shout out to Drake. Everybody's saying Drake. Oh, it ain't even me.
Travis.
Say Drake, it's not me, Joel.
And Travis, too, because I know Travis finna drop this year.
Hey, yo, don't let pubic braids, I mean, beard over here confuse you. I like J. Cole.
You said pubic braids.
I like J. Cole, all right? J. Cole, I respect you, bro. I'm just giving my honest opinion. This dude's over here, you know, sprinkling a bunch of nonsense on it.
Because I like music. You can't understand it. It's all right.
Yo, it's your boy Wells, the anime king. And don't let the Drake stands spin the narrative here, guys. J. Cole dropped an amazing album. Look what's doing to hip hop. He drops an album. We got Nicki Minaj dropping.
Yeah.
We got Migos dropping again. Kodak Black.
Yeah.
This boy Drake been dropping since COVID and hip hop been trash. J. Cole is back, baby. Whoa. Don't hate.
Yo, keep the same energy, certified lover, boy.
Watch. You see, Wells gonna break this couch.
Yo, this one, this clip is gonna be played in that video. That's what I'm saying.
The round table.